Okay, hi everyone. Welcome to the first meeting of the consumer behavior class. Today we'll be talking about consumer behavior, its origins and strategic applications. We have here myself, Safira, and Pak Rahmat also joining in on this session. Hello, Pak Rahmat.
Hi, Safira. Hi, everyone. Good to see you all in this class. Hope we will have a good adventure with good perspective to the topic of consumer behavior throughout this semester.
Great. Sounds like fun. I'm also looking forward to this class a lot because this is the first time I'm teaching this class. Anyway, without further ado, let's begin with the presentation. So in today's meeting, we will be talking about a few things. The first one is what is consumer behavior? What is the marketing concept? What is the marketing mix? How technology plays a role in consumer behavior? The concept of societal marketing? And lastly, a simplified model of consumer decision making. By the end of this meeting, you should be able to understand or explain these concepts. You don't have to think a lot about them now because we will be explaining each concept one by one during the course of this meeting. So, what is consumer behavior, Pak Rahmat?
Well, what is consumer behavior? Theoretically, conceptually, and practically, I think it's very interesting to think about. Theoretically, consumer behavior covers all the process from the mental processes before the consumer is making decision about the purchase, up to the process of the stage when the consumer uses what he or she already purchased, and when they evaluate what they have purchased and they use whether what they purchased was meeting what they wanted to when they were planning to buy that one or not. So whether to repeat the purchase or not, up to the process when what they purchased was no longer economically viable to be continually being used. So entering the state of disposing the product. So in very short, the consumer behavior cover these long processes from mental process behavior until the states of post-consumption behavior to make it complex, I think like that. Oh, maybe you can make it simpler.
I think that's a really great explanation. Maybe I can just chip in with an example. So a consumer behavior is not only about buying things, for instance, why you buy a certain product from a certain brand, but it's also about, for instance, what pops up in your mind when I say the word toothpaste. Here in Indonesia, you think of Pepsodent, or when I say motorbike, you think of Honda. But it also talks about the process of changing brands. So for instance, you've been using Samsung cell phone for 10 years, and this year after the new iPhone was launched, you decided to buy the new iPhone instead of buying a new Samsung. So it covers a wide range of behaviors and not just buying. I guess that's a more like concrete way to describe what consumer behavior is.
Yeah, from the example, we can see that even the very ordinary behavior that we do every day, actually there is very deep and complex mental processes in which psychology is the science which is being designed to explain all this process. And by understanding the science of psychology, we can see how we can apply it in order to influence or assist both the consumer as well as the marketer. So I think that's what makes consumer behavior is a very interesting area of study. That's from my perspective, I think.
Yeah, that's very true. A lot of things that you learn from consumer behavior, you can really apply it into your own life. After learning consumer behavior, I myself started to realize a lot of little things that I didn't realize before, such as why I like to buy candy near the checkout. It's because my blood sugar has lowered by the time I have finished shopping and stuff like that. Those are really interesting things you get to know about yourself after you learn consumer behavior. So yeah, great. We hope that you learn a lot of these things and learn a lot about yourself by the end of the course. Now, swiftly moving on, consumer behavior is actually an interdisciplinary field. It's a combination of economics, psychology, sociology, and also anthropology. Maybe I'd give it to Pak Rahmat to explain more about these subfields and how they contribute to consumer behavior.
Yeah, consumer behavior cover and relevant to all of these perspectives from the economics perspective, for example, because when we are about to decide to buy or not to buy, we always have a consideration of whether it is useful or not, whether the price is okay or not, both in terms of the value of what we are purchasing or in terms of the needs that we have at that point. And deciding whether to buy or not is a kind of rational consideration process, involve rational consideration process, in which economics is science about this making of rational decision. But consumer behavior is not all rational behavior. Many aspects of our consumer behavior is mostly influenced by some emotion and also influenced by the presence of other people, which then can be called as social processes and consumer behavior. And this aspect is studied by psychology. But the consumer behavior is not single behavior. All of the human being, especially in this market, what is called as market economy, in which the people cannot fully, I mean, they cannot satisfy, they cannot make all what they need for their life, and they depends on some other to produce, for example, the rice we have to buy from the farmer, the clothes that they are wearing is depends on the long chains of production from the cotton into the productions of the fabrics and into the process of making up the clothes and so on. And that's from what is called a society, economic society, and the sociologists, the discipline which give us understanding of the economic behavior, consumer behavior in the societal context. And throughout the time, consumer behavior form kinds of the cultural level of the behavior, in which anthropology studies consumer behavior in different types of culture, different facets of the cultural life of the consumer. So by combining this all discipline, we can get a better understanding of consumer behavior. And from these disciplines, we can see psychology, which play part in the microscopic analysis of the behavior or micro level analysis of the behavior, will play important roles in understanding consumer behavior in the broader market related processes in which belongs to economic studies, and also provide a clear understanding of the behavior at the societal level, which is the sociology, and up into the anthropology level. So one and another are interrelated. Over to you, Zafira.
Yeah, thank you for Pak Rahmat. I think that's a very thorough explanation already. I'd just like to note how interesting it is that you said how economics is a really rational field of study, but our behavior, any sort of behavior, isn't entirely rational. So we can't entirely use economics to explain consumer behavior, which is why we also have to use a psychological perspective. There's a really good author and a really good researcher in consumer behavior. His name is Dan Ariely, and he says that our behavior is irrational, but it is predictably irrational, which is why we can actually research it. We can find a pattern in that irrationality, which is why we do consumer research and consumer behavior research.
Yeah, like Dan Ariely to some of his writing, very inspiring. And he has also a kind of blogs in which he provide many interesting examples of the how a consumer behavior are mostly not rational behavior. So exciting to read his writing.
Yeah, maybe some of you guys would like to have some a bit of like a nonfiction read. You can go ahead and look. You can go ahead and search for his book online or in the bookstore. Still related to this interdisciplinary topic, I'd like to ask you, how is marketing and consumer behavior related, Pak Rahmat?
Marketing and consumer behavior are two, almost we can say as two sides of the same coins. Marketings play the part in terms of bringing the product into the consumers, and in order to be able to bring the product successfully, introduce the product to the consumer successfully, influence the consumer to buy the product, we need to understand the consumer behavior from the consumer side, whereas the marketing is from the what's so-called as producer side. So the two cannot be separated. We can understand consumer behavior in purely scientific terms, but unless we use the knowledge into practice, which is the marketing, then the knowledge will not have kind of a big significant impact on the economy itself. So and the marketer will not be able to do their trade, to do their work successfully, unless they are understanding consumer behavior, which is more of psychological analysis to consumer. I think that's how I see the relationship between these two domains of activity.
That's entirely true. I also agree with that. I asked that because in the following slides and in the whole course, actually, we will be talking a lot about marketing. And I wanted to make sure that it's clear to the students that consumer behavior and marketing are actually concepts that overlap and are actually, as you said, the same side of a coin. So yeah, we can move on to the next slide. So here's two types of consumers. There's organizational consumers and personal consumers. Organizational consumers are essentially government agencies or businesses who buy goods for their own needs. So, sorry, not for their own needs, for the needs of their organization. Meanwhile, personal consumers are those who buy needs for personal reasons, for their self, for their family members and their friends. In terms of consumer behavior, we will be talking more about personal consumers and not so much about organizational consumers. Do you agree with that, Pak Rahmat?
Yes, exactly. I'd like just to add some other information in which in business, then you will maybe you will find terms of P2P business and P2C business. P2P business means the relationship between business and business. That means the producer is a business organization, the consumer is the business organization as well, but the government as well as the private sector. The consumer behavior is more related to the P2C business to consumer business, in which the consumers is the end user of the product and services. Consumer behavior is, of course, more to do with the understanding of the individual consumer, but by individual, that would not be necessarily limited to individual person, because we also study in terms of the unit of family, for example, and group processes of consumption. So that's what Well, that's what I see of the difference between these two types of consumer.